Hi VC, George back with another video. And today I'm just gonna show the rest of the albums I've got in the last 2 or 3 weeks, I guess. So the first one I got was Trespass by Ry Cooder. This was a movie from, oh, I don't know, 1992, I think. Originally it came out in CD. This is first time on vinyl, and it's by Music on Vinyl, the release, and my number is 637 off 1,000 copies. It's on red vinyl. Insert. So we have Ry Cooder, the main albums, Ry Cooder on guitar, obviously, Jim Keltner and John Hassell. And it's a typical Ry Cooder soundtrack, really. Songs here. Good to have. Next one I got was The Killing Joke, and there's a wee antiques shop that has a record section about 30 miles away from me in Berwick. I think I got that from here, there. The Killing Joke, and it's called Revelations. A bit Masonic symbolism there. Illuminati dollar bill sign. And The Killing Joke are, this was from 1982. Killing Joke are sort of post-punk indie sort of gothy type band. It's a good album. Killing Joke. Next one was a great find. It's Magazine. Got this off eBay, I think. Yeah, eBay. And this is from 2011. And it was pretty limited. It's quite hard to find. I had the CD. So this was a reform magazine. Magazine, when they first formed, they were done about 4 or maybe 5 albums, disbanded, got back together again in 2011, released this LP. It's the last thing they've done, Know Thyself. And the band are, there's an insert here, it's just the lyrics on the inner, and a wee. And that's Howard Devoto. Three of the original bands. We've got Dave Formula on keyboards, John Doyle on drums, new guy called Stan on bass, and Noko on guitar. So just missing John McGough, famous, brilliant guitarist. But it's a good album. Very good. Love Magazine. Although their album, if you buy one album to get Magazine, the first one I always think is the live album Play. This is quite a good album. Know Thyself. Next, I bought this yesterday. The Police's Greatest Hits, Every Breath You Take, I think from 1986. That's the inner. A nice sweet PVC inner inside there, it's quite good. All our hits on it, 12 tracks, 3, 6, 12 tracks. I've got the Police box set, so this is nice. I was looking for this, it's nice and easy to go to. Save me going out the box set, it's nice to have all our hits on one album. And it flows really well, so a good album. Great album. The Police. Next one is Milt Jackson, jazz album called Goodbye with Hubert Laws. This is on the CTI label. Also on here are Ron Carter, Billy Cobham, Mike Gadd, Herbie Hancock, Freddie Hubbard and Cedar Walton. The album, The Gatefold. Milt Jackson is a vibes player. Plays the vibes. Lovely. Hubert Laws is playing flute. And this was recorded, remember, I think this was the 70s. Yeah, 72. I think it was released in about 74. Nice album. Milt Jackson, Goodbye. Next one we have on Blue Note, Jimmy Smith. Jimmy Smith's an organ player. And we also have Lee Morgan, Lou Donaldson, George Coleman, Tina Brooks, Kenny Burrell, Eddie McFadden, Art Blakey, and Donald Bailey on drums. What a lineup. Great album. I think this copy's about, it's a French copy, I think, on DMM. Originally released in 1958. This is a 1984 copy. Blue Note label. Jimmy Smith on organ. The Sermon. Very good again. Next album I bought yesterday at my local record shop I've got here. And it's Double Basses. And it's by Nels Henning Ostred Pedersen on one bass and Sam Jones on the second bass. Other members of the band are Philip Catherine on guitar, Billy Higgins on drums and Albert Heath on percussion. This was recorded in 1976 and it's on a Danish label. This is a Dutch reissue. 78, I think. Really good. Two basses play off well. There's loads of acoustic guitar in it too, so not too heavy. A nice album. So that's Double Bass. Next one, Tone Poet. Now everybody who shows jazz shows Tone Poets, but this is by Cassandra Wilson. And it's called Glamoured, and it's the only double album on the Tone Poet series, I think. It's lovely, beautiful voice. This was recorded in, or first released in 2000, I'm still stuck in the 90s. 2003. Just released last year on the Tone Poet. Beautiful, great, solely jazz voice. Cassandra Wilson. A nice change in the Tone Poet series. Oh, it's on the Blue Note label. Cassandra Wilson, Glamoured. Really good. Now next we have, getting through them fast as usual, this was recommended by Dean, Grandma's Handbag down in Australia, in Sydney I think he is. was an American folk singer-songwriter, guitarist called Jackson C. Frank. The album's just called Jackson C. Frank. So this was released in 1965. Jackson came over to the UK to work in the folk scene in the UK. And there he met, at the same time, Paul Simon was also here. So Paul Simon recorded him. And this is the only album he released, as again, tragically, another folk artist. I think he took his own life. Another troubled soul. Anyway, you can. There's a couple of albums out of his demo stuff and whatever, as usual. It's a good addition to the folk singer-songwriter collection I'm getting at the moment. Jackson C. Frank, produced by Paul Simon. Really nice. Last but not least, I picked up an upgrade copy of Joni Mitchell's Mingus when I was at the antiques container thing a couple of weeks ago, two, 3 weeks ago. Already had it. The cover's a bit scruffy, but the vinyl cleaned up really well and it was better than my other copy. It's a fantastic album. One of the must in the Joni Mitchell. Catalogue. Someone on it, who's on it? Stanley Clark on bass, Jan Hammer on Mini Moog, John McLaughlin's on guitar, Jerry Mulligan on baritone sax, Phil Woods, alto sax, Eddie Gomez on bass, and John Guerin on drums. So I think what happened with this album is Joni Mitchell got Mingus to write some music. Fantastic album. I don't think he lived a hell of a lot longer actually, to this album being made and it was released. '79. Fab album. Joni Mitchell, Mingus, Essential. Okay. Hope you enjoyed that, folks. Another quickie. And I'll catch you next week. Bye now.